Made good progress, actually. That's nice. So, let me check the tools that we have. Wait, why can't I interact? I can't. Oh.
It's the letter
My
O
bad.
and the cool piece of toilet paper is stuck to the back. Yes, you can piece them together using the alphanumeric code on the margin. It always begins with HDB41, then date of initialization and time of arrival on the scene, followed by the title. For example, HDB41120117. Why, yes. Your precinct number is 41.
41.
Every last alphanumeric in the files begins with it. And these
41.
Are your case files. It's safe to say HDB are your initials.
HDB. I don't know what to say to that.
That is improbable. It takes about half an hour to piece one together, using the system you've devised. Where do you want to start?
Alright, let me see. The unsolvable case, I'm curious.
AKA Leslie and Burke. AKA the public indecency
Here's
drunk
damage.
And the property damage drunk is a cursed case. It has been passed from unsuspecting officer to unsuspecting officer for 10 years. Leslie will always take his pants off when he's drunk. Burke will always trash everything. It's just what they do. It is their nature. You cannot change the nature of a... The only way for Leslie to stop displaying his genitals and for Burke to stop attacking things would be for them to stop drinking alcohol, which in their 40s or 50s, it's hard to tell because of their distorted features, is a medical improbability. You would think that, but you're wrong. Where's the fun in exposing your genitals or breaking stuff in your... Can you keep yourself off the street? Threatening fines, dragging them to the station, locking them up in the hell holes they live in, locking them up in the station, hypnotherapy, even trying to get the local gang of Zemia. It's plain to see from the files that you, Satellite Officer JV, and Special Consultant TH, had more important cases to attend to. You uncover cross-reference to several ongoing investigations, each brought to a standstill every time you drive down Main Street. Because there they are, on the corner of Perdition. Good, you're learning. If the files are to be trusted, that's all there is to it. That and Burke breaking things, and the fact that they're both... He must have it confused with the property he likes to damage. But the joke's on him. You're drunk out of your mind on potent Pilsner. You slam the hardened plastic board. In the process, the ledger sustains damage. The compartment within, reserved for permeable documents, is jammed shut. You stop your assault. He came at us, and at us. I think he was trying to kill Burko. While trying to kill Burko, you slowly come around. The permeable's compartment is open. You've smashed, can't get out of his apartment. An invalid, with Burke to tend to, which is also why the officer responsible. Not much has changed in the meanwhile. A bunch of sodden papers still sags from the clipboard.
Alright, we can check this later, I think. It's just taking so much time too. Okay. What is this? RCM. What is this? Wait. How do we... Hold on, let me check the controls. Here are the controls. Anyways. Let me check the journal again. So we have to talk with this guy. What's his name? Starting with E. Find your other shoe. We did already. Victim statues. Kuno. Kuno is the kid, of course. Of course. Kid.
So you tried to kill Kuno's girl.
Bro, shut up.
What's up with that?
I don't want to
Wanna
talk with
talk
this
about
guy.
it?
Boy. But I didn't shoot her, I just aim.
Not all of us.
No one's moving anywhere. Kuno knows where you sleep. The pig who fucked his window up. I'm gonna climb in through that balcony, put the fucking knife in you. But you and Kuno are good for now. Pals?
The determination in his voice leaves little room for doubt in his sincerity.
One word out of you, pig shite, and you're locked out of the Kuno experience.
You hear the Kuno?
And you're back in business with the Kuno. Now what is it?
Fucking Kuno.
Right, pig. This is where Kuno plays with his little wooden choo-choo. What do you want with it?
The dead man's clothes were in the trash continue, pointed to continue. What did they? How did they get there?
Yeah, Kuno doesn't know shit about that. That shit is beneath Kuno.
I need to know. It could be a lead in the investigation. Someone may have tempered the murder scene.
Listen, listen. Kuno doesn't care about this small-time shit. Kuno could hook you up with some sweet rags. Shit like Kuno's wearing? Your size, good price, 500 real. Look, Kuno ain't seen shit lying around, except for that there. Now you want performance gear or...
The lieutenant remains silent, but his expression couldn't say, I told you so, any louder.
Whatever, Kuno was trying to help you. But you're too fat for falling anyway, pig.
There is also a mug in the trash. The ladder ever climbed it? Pointed it.
That's just some shit, roofing gear.
There it is. That strange feeling again. As if there was more than meets the eye about that pile of roofing material.
Yeah. Some shit gimps left behind were those gimps. Suddenly you raise your eyes, left-handed.
The fuck are you
trying to get you to talk, gimp, Kuno? Don't talk.
Inner eye.
They're trying to make-
You glance again at the roofing material in front of the shack. Yes, you should go back there.
Dunno. Kipta's gardener used to work there. Yeah, that's what Kuno said. She couldn't handle the heat, so she took off. Kuno can take it. Look it up in the library. Kuno's not a fucking dictionary.
Kuno.
Fucking small brain. Kuno means the gardener, alright? Look, Kuno doesn't explain shit. Kuno just says shit.
Yeah, her. What was she doing in the greenhouse in March anyway? What kind of gardening is done in... Yes, it seems suspicious. You don't like things being like that. Suspicious.
Look at that fucking shit. You try... Fuck, does Kuno know? Kuno's...
The lieutenant takes a quick note in his notebook.
It's a trap, Kuno! Don't climb it, Kuno!
The fuck? A mug in the trash? Is this about the fucking clothes again?
Does this racist mug have anything to do with it? What mug though? I don't remember the mug. Does it... I don't wanna ask something like wrong. Does this queen's better not taking out of its historical context mug have anything to do?
Yeah, Kuno sees where this is going. Kuno's got that fast brain.
Pass, babe.
You pigs are after the mug fucker.
I can't hear you, Kuno. Speak louder, Kuno.
The yellow. Is it really yellow?
Yes, that Kuno doesn't know who put that shit in there. And if he did,
tell the Kuno who it was.
Stop turning into a pig, Kuno! Yeah, get your bacon shit away. Yeah, whatever. Kuno doesn't give a shit.
The body, what do you know about it? I have more questions about the crime.
Shitload pig. Don't tell the pig shit, Kuno!
If I were to want to waste my time, which I do not, I would ask them who he is, how he got there, and the usual.
Just a couple of pigs sniffing around in the dirt. That seems pretty fucking... Yeah, you tell the faggoty, Kuno!
Did you do that? I don't think he did it. I don't think so.
Kuno's fucking... Kuno uses the fucking for target practice.
Target practice?
Fuck are you talking about? What is this?
He says you're stupid, Kuno. They want to make you stupid again.
Oh, did Kuno make your shit sniffing harder? Obstruction of shit sniffing. This is Kuno's kingdom. Kuno.
You hear the lieutenant hum.
Kuno doesn't give a shit about the armor. Kuno's fuckgimp's got one big look at him. Fucking growth hormone shit. He said Kuno doesn't give a shit about that freak armor. Kuno tried to get the helmet on. It was too big. Kuno kicked that shit in the sea, rugby style. That shit means nothing to Kuno. Yeah? That shit means nothing to Kuno. Kuno doesn't give a shit about... You wanna fuck on someone about that armor? Go fuck the mustached union. Yeah, cocking boot. You know that jolly union cow fucker? So yeah, he's the one you want to talk to. He's fucking crazy about that armor shit. Coming here pretending like he likes cows. Trying to catch a peep of Kuno's armor.
Yes, this troubadour has it. You can
probably climbed. Kuno was busy down the road when that shit went down. You heard Kuno. Kuno wasn't even in Martinez. Kuno wasn't in Revachol. Kuno wasn't regional. I don't know. Some fuck Mesk or I don't know, some other place. Night City. Kuno is in fucking Night City. Kuno gives this info out on a need to know basis. And you.
Thanks, Kuno. That's
your test.
Get lost!
Kuno doesn't.
Oh, fuck Kuno, man. Kuno, 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 Kuno. Oh my goodness. Can I just walk over here? I can't. Why not? Why not? Hello, why not? Why? Is it- am I missing something? What? I'm trying to get here. I can't, though.
An inconspicuous
Kuno to see.
The roofing material of Eternite. Because there's a secret door hidden behind the panels of Eternite. There it is. You see a shabby little door.
Alright, let's see.
What is this then? A tool shed?
I don't know. Let's see. An empty tube of Magnus alum, magnesium.
Be still, my beating heart. It's amphetamine. Sweet amphetamine. The lieutenant isn't studying the powder in the mirror. He's studying you.
Perhaps not. This is below our pay grade, detective. See that ladder there? It's probably another way into the industrial harbor.
Interesting. Get out of the way. Okay. Docked up. Money. Interesting. Oh, this is... What is that? jacket, coat. Where are you going, man? Hello, I just clicked here. What is she doing? The store is going to the collapse. This mug, yellow. So this place... can we... What else can we do? Oh. To the dynamics, dynamics. Oh my god,
like
dynamics.
Cloak on the
anyways, dynamites. To the dynamites. I was gonna say dynamite. Oh my god. Okay, I'm gonna shut up. I'm just gonna shut up. 2D game, basically. Okay.
Probably yours.
So cringe.
There's
right
the
now.
RCM insignia, and you have a habit. You could probably make a jump. You look like you've done some track and field in your day.
I don't think I can jump. Dynamics.
Aggressive up here. The lieutenant looks at the enormous crane towering in the distance. Over, the look in his eyes is a mix of the engineer-like interest and the wonder of a six-year-old seeing a horse for the first time. His eyes trace the crane's contour, as if trying to memorize its majestic shape.
Yes, we were in the middle of something, your clock.
That's cute. So, I don't think I should jump.
I do think it's yours, yes. As to whether you should go for it, well, it doesn't seem too dangerous. 2 meter stops, whenever you're ready.
The cloak looks like
okay, I'm gonna jump, fuck it. I can't. Can I? No success. Whoopsies. I mean, it's not high. Come on.
Nope. You could have done.
Hey, hey. What happened? I understand. We can always come back when you are feeling better. It's just a.
Fuck it. All right. How did we... Let's go here. What is this box? Hold on. Oh. Okay. That door? Let me see. It's almost 5 p.m. And I guess we're down here, aren't we? I don't think we can do something else. What if I do this? It's fine, right? It's fine. So, okay. Let me see. Who else has unauthorized access to the rolling trash? Yeah, I have no idea.
Yes?
Inside, you see a set of steering levers, a radio microphone, a pull-out tool.
This is Precinct 57. How may I assist you? Sir, officer, what's the number? And the make of the armor, if you know it. Got it. I'll contact the SCP database immediately. Call back tomorrow. Hopefully they'll have dug up something useful. Was there anything else? 57.
In the cabin, you see...
Alrighty. We did that back in the day for I skimmed to tell you about the case. Getting the hangman boots. Get boots off. Oh yeah, we forgot to get the boots. We don't want Kuno to steal them. Kuno. Run. Walking. Yeah, let's get the boots.
The rotting man. The lieutenant adjusts his glasses and takes a deep breath.
I thought we decided to leave it to processing.
Okay, so you can sneak out of your room maybe after he's gone asleep.
Should we do it or not? I feel like should wait for autopsy first.
Come on, officer. You know what a field autopsy is. You've done 100 of them. Unfortunately, no.
Oh wait, I have...
They're better than nothing.
Yeah. So
that's right.
The dead man stares in silence as you crack open the ledger. The bright red paper above those, an 11 field info form, needs filling out first.
That's you.
The corpse is indifferent to your scribblings.
KK57.
KK equals Kim Kitsuragi. 57 equals Precinct 57. Followed by his date, 0803, and time of arrival, 0815, on the scene. He's indexed the case after himself.
Next. NA. NA. Roughly 50.
Dry 40. The damage is so extensive, it's better to err on the young side. He nods.
Mondial.
The pudgy mess of curdled meat looks neither mondial.
Fucky fucky!
Fucky fucky.
Male.
Pigs can have sex!
Bro, this kid is fucked up, bro. Oh my god. Fucky, fucky. What the hell?
Nor does he look male with his pregnant belly and...
We're still going with March 4th, 51.
Pregnant? Yeah.
What else?
Okay.
KK.
None. At least not after the initial examination.
Interesting.
A silent nod. The lieutenant, your central nervous system recognizes this gesture. It's the stations of the breath. Ecclesiastic, religious in nature, a holdout from pre-Delorium. Somewhere in Jamrock North, a small woodshed behind Rosencrantz Row, Lieutenant Nick Feuerbach puts his hand elsewhere yet. An obese female sits in a wicker chair, her silhouette ball-like against the window. Outside, Grand Coudon, the day is turning dim for Sergeant Mac Dawson. And so, all across Jamrock, Coal City,
we should start the postmortem.
The corpse cannot feel Kim's hand on his chest. It no longer meaningfully interacts with its surroundings. A thicket of boxes and lists on red copier paper tries to answer why.
Clothes. The deceased wears armored boots and white briefs. The make of the briefs is Babroudin, I think. Let's see.
See?
Babroudin, yes. Inexpensive. Size M.
The disappointment is palpable. The red-haired thing.
The boots are ceramic, vitreous enamel. They are fused to his skin from blood flowing downward post-mortem.
It would be clever of you to omit the boots altogether, sire. If you are to keep them for yourself, as you ought to, you have deserved them more than anyone else.
The boot has a serial number. It's E50.100.100. Tattoos. The upper torso is covered in a single, continuous tattoo, resembling a map of the night sky. It reaches from the right shoulder to the heart. The assistant has a color photograph of the markings, to be added to the case files as document A1. The deceased has a cargo lashing belt around his neck, tied with a hangman's knot. Well-nourished, athletically built, measuring 1.8 meters, generally consistent with age 42. Preserved body hair is light brown. Distribution is consistent with the age. The deceased had male pattern baldness. Hair is combed back, short. Lividity is consistent with hanging. The head is congested. Contusions are present on the head, chest, and thighs.
Fucking low velocity? Talking shit about...
In addition, there are bite marks on the face, scalp, and chest, consistent with predation.
Bite marks?
Ligature mark.
The steel wiring. There's too much of it. We need to remove the belt, so...
You got just the right tool for that. The chain cutters. The hanged man lets out a joyous little bubble of rot from his nose.
Always good to think ahead. We need to cut the belt to see the ligature mark below.
See?
No, he ain't. Your pig's a boring fuck.
The belt is equally tight around the whole circumference of his neck, swelling over the edges like white bread rising from the yeast.
Mm-hmm.
You jam the cutters right under the knot. That seems like a smart idea.
Fuck it, fuck.
Yeah, somewhere there. Or a really, really bad smell is coming from there now.
Yeah,
told you my...
I should have a go first. I think I have a strategy.
He sinks the snap. The knot is slashed.
Here. The rope rises to a point, leaving a gap in the ligature mark. The suspension point. Hemorrhaging is observed on the skin, above and below the ligature mark. The mark is chest is intact. Normal contour. Abdomen is protuberant. Pelvis intact. Genitalia.
No!
I fucking...
This is clearly what they've been waiting for. Ever since the autopsy.
Genitalia is male and unremarkable. No evidence of injury.
Do we need to inspect? I don't think we do.
Back is symmetrical and intact. Upper and lower extremities are intact, but asymmetrical. There are combat injuries on the right hand. In addition, I see smaller, residual scars, too numerous to count, covering about 30% of his skin.
From wounds sustained over 2, maybe more decades, dispersal and accumulation indicates long and active.
Mm-hmm. We have a real museum here. Last item, hands.
His flesh is cold.
Pleased to meet you. Where are you from and what's your name? I'm only fucking with you. I know where you're from. From Cappadocia. And your name is Il Corbo. What can I do you for, Il Corbo di Cappadocia?
Nothing does. This was pleasurable. I sincerely thank you. We should do this more often. Be close like this, I mean.
Hands are clean. No sign of injury.
It's depressing.
Ooh. That's all for the external. Well done. What next?
Central nervous system.
Of course, there is a moral to be drawn from it. A moral to this story.
Musculoskeletal.
With his eyes almost closed, the lieutenant puts his hand on the...
Yeah, Jack!
The hyoid bone is fractured. The rest of the musculoskeletal system is intact. Respiratory system. Oral cavity shows no lesions. The victim has received dental implants, possibly after a combat wound. Mouth swollen. Hemorrhaging present in mucosa of the lips and mouth.
No scream. No sigh of relief rises from the darkness inside. It's humid there. Sickly sweet. It's hard. What inside?
There are ancient mysteries down there.
Hemorrhaging present in mucus.
Yeah. That must have been bad.
Same for toxicology and serology. NA. Cardiovascular. The body. Gastrointestinal.
This will do.
Digested semi-solid food in stomach. Voila. What's next on the list? Let's see. We have bite marks, contusions on the head and chest, and a ligature mark encircling the neck.
Mm. Bite marks are weird.
Head, chest, and scalp bite mark injuries. Predation by birds has caused damage to the body.
Birds, okay.
And your opinion, officer? Agreed. Next injury? Oh, so we inflicted them? You mean the incision on the thorax from a chain cutter? That was not a team effort, and I wouldn't mention it. Maddie's the injuries. So, the scalp bleeds from a post-mortem head injury, a stone. The injury does not have the rim of an early...
At maximum velocity!
...has confessed to causing it at maximum velocity.
Coagulated blood sticks to his scalp and chest, where the countless stones have hit the dead man. Beneath, the description of injury. Two boxes.
Right. Next. A dark red abraded ligature mark encircling the neck, with a gap on the nape measuring... I see hemorrhaging on the skin, above and below the ligature mark. Depth of the...
Below the note, two customary boxes wait to be ticked. The man's head jerks to the side. The ring around his neck is visible.
That's it. We have established cause of death. It's not much. Let's wrap this up. I pronounce this field autopsy over. I need a copy of that autopsy form for processing.
He's thinking, did I miss something? You tilt your head. Also, I'm sure we didn't get everything. There's always something.
Shoot, Looney Rooney.
Oh yes, Kobo Milobo. In the gift horse's mouth. Tracts and wakes and waterways. Ancient materials. It's all right. Come back later, Kobo.
Wow, it's...
Amuse yourself with my friend manners and my memento.
Let's back him, take him away. Let's deeply turn on
him. Also, see me in your dreams.
Okay, I need a little help for carrying him to the holding pen of my kinema.
There go those beautiful enamel boots. May they rest in processing.
It's too late to take him into processing today. I'll take him first thing tomorrow.
Honestly, taking the boots is just a weird option, okay? It's just awkward. Why would I do that? I don't want to do that. So, let me see. What do we need? I don't know what to get. Actually, let's get perception. Seems nice. Yeah. Wait, did I? Alright. So. So what should we do now? Let me see. Gardening. Singing. Yeah, we need to talk with Kim, I guess. Let's talk with the gardener. It's not 9 PM yet, so we can go and talk with that guy.
Snowing again. It felt like springtime just a few days ago. Well, this might be the last snow we get. At least I hope so. Snow has nutrients in it, helps everything green up in the spring. At least that's what my grandma always told me.
All you can see really? Is the fact that her skin is a different color from yours. That's literally all. You're gonna have to run with that.
What? No, I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that. Go back. No. Why would you... I cannot believe this, bro. Literally 72%. How can this be a failure? I don't get it. I'm not saying this. Bro, I'm not saying this. How do I go back? Alright.
What does that mean? I don't know. Whatever's on the radio, I guess. What does this have to do with snow or gardening in March?
I know, right?
Than Cornet.
They listen to Disco.
Okay.
I'm not having this conversation. I have to leave. Sorry. Sorry to bother you. That's such an awkward conversation. Imagine having a conversation like that. So bad. So, that doesn't work. Victim's tattoos. Man. Wait, there's a new guy.
That sugary black rum stain on the counter makes you teary-eyed with joy. It's almost touching how syrupy and sticky it is. How long have you been up already? Oh, excuse me. Do you have something better to do than lust for sweet syrupy rum and lemonade?
Yeah. I'm gonna talk with this guy. You gotta spend money to make money. I see.
Can I help you?
What was that purple thing? Did I put it? I guess it's gone. So, we can't enter there.
You see, a heavy, the cobalt blue, sir. It leads to a side building. The door does not.
Mm-mm.
Yes? What do you want to know?
If we are from different precinct,
I'm afraid you and I are pawns in a pissing competition.
His disdain is clear.
Pissing competition.
Man, not you.
You don't know? I assumed you were in on it. That's good. Better still than an imbecilic cop-off. It's just stupidity. The cop kind. Our precincts can decide if Martinez is part of Gemrock or the Industrial Harbor. Yours or mine, as if we somehow own parts of the city. Typical street gang mentality. So we've let the union make a mockery of law enforcement here. And, well, sort of. It's less a matter of who gets to police. I think the dispatch desk just told both our stations about the hanging. There was quite the brouhaha at the 57th, I can tell you that. Time to settle it, they said. Cop off. But I assure you, I am not their finest or toughest with 102 cases solved. What I am is least interested in a piece.
So, he volunteered to represent the 57th, but not out of competitiveness. On the contrary.
Yes, it's a wholly pointless matter. Forget I ever mentioned it.
Look at you. It's because you're a failure. They sent you to slight Precinct 57. Just think about it for a second. You're a raging alcoholic who showed up 3 days late wearing piss stain. Of course, it's only a theory. Whatever their reasoning, there's nothing written that says you have to prove them right.
What do you want to know? No, it's not a particularly mysterious case.
The lieutenant adjusts.
Good.
Okay, is it done? It's like, I don't really have to know something particular. Right, like... Or is it talk to... No? Interesting. I don't want to say that, like, I literally didn't even forget anything. I don't get
this
it.
Is high. For the rest of the world, the ace is high is just a cool Revachol thing. Politically neutral. In Revachol, it still holds revolutionary connotations. Also, have you looked at Lieutenant Kitsuragi's clothes? He wears a bomber jacket, just like the one.
Okay.
Yes? What do you want to know?
Yes. The case 3 days ago, the RCM emergencies desk received a report about a security guard who was found hanged in During that time, the victim had been stripped of his belongings. The caller did not identify him, but used the word lynching. There is an ongoing labor dispute between the local dock workers and the logistics company while a security guard or worker of some sort hired by Wild Pines. This was just hearsay from Martinez, of course. They didn't identify themselves in any way. The tone was muffled using a device of some sort. There's a strong prejudice against involving the RCM in what's seen as union matters. The dock workers' union is the de facto police in Martinez. Now it appears they've started executing too. We cannot allow that. That's us, the Revachol Citizens Militia. We're the... Just to be clear, we are police officers. It's our job to find the killer. That's the case. You mean like a brief? Do you want me to brief you again? There's no reason. 3 days ago, during that time, okay then. Was good.
Ready. We'll finish that probably right now. Right? Thank you. Okay, so... their reality lowdown. I don't want to do that. I actually found my other shoe, I don't get it. What the hell? Don't I have my shoe? I do have my shoe. What do you mean? Why is that quest not complete? Task. I don't get it. I do have my shoe. Interesting. Are you able to inspect them? I don't know, am I? No? No.
There they both are. Two identical shoes.
Interesting.
Like two baby crocodiles. Go ahead.
I see. That's weird. Alright, let's see what else we can do. Union boss. Alright, let's go to Harvard then. Is this a big guy?
Right to work! Right to
have fun. Union shits are on full strike. Don't think they're going to let you through the gate.
Right to work!
It's shameful. Cops doing nothing. You should bring backup. Open up the gates for us. Blockading gainful employment for workers is a crime.
We are not picking a side in this, just a pity.
Let us work!
I was just messing with you. No, imagine, you cops going on a strike, but then another cop comes in and says, let us cop for less money. Speaking of, what brings the RCM here, to the Wild North? Come to see the strife? The little boy had the good on his promise, to get me into trouble, to sick the pigs on.
What happened?
I was asked to look into that armor situation.
Did you?
At first I thought, why not? Maybe the pieces can feed the strike. So I went to this boy. He said he'll make me his prison bitch. He's got eyes everywhere, and the cop serves me right for doing menial footwork. I dropped that probe right then and there, and it still got me into trouble. One bad move is all it takes. It's a minor nuisance. It's all good. I learned that people don't want to talk to a drunk unit.
What else?
Not much. Technical stuff, mostly. I did some research into this armadura. Let's say I have friends at the library. I didn't get into the material science.
Mm. How does it come up?
In parts. 4 in total. The helmet was the first to go. The kid says he tore it off and kicked it into the sea.
Yeah.
I believe it. The boots were still on the guy last I saw. So, as I count, there are 2 parts missing. The gauntlets and the cuirass. This is where I left off. Too much hassle. I guess you won't be collecting them all then. That's less work for you at least. Oh, they're just gone. They don't exist anymore, if they ever did at all. Forget about them. I do.
Nice and balanced. Some junior officer.
Smart choice. It's only that one spot you need armor too. The one the bullet hits. Good luck if you go for those boots though. No problem.
He is sincerely grateful. He is not tracking down pieces of armor right now.
Oh. Good, good. What matters do you want to discuss with Everard? So mysterious, so intriguing. Either way, the road in front of you is... I don't operate in that capacity. I'm not...
If it's so simple, why did the scab lead?
I walk right past my... Yeah, the 2.5 meter tall Semini supremacist there. Walk right past him. Then press the button to unlock the door. Then go past him again. And you enter the arbor through the office. Está.
The man whispers a jaunty tune. A coastal...
Alright. I don't like this. Hello there. Hello there. Oh my god.
Your body betrays your
Yeah, Measurehead. His body totally betrays his degeneracy.
My My body does not betray my degeneracy. My body is an important member of the police. We need to get into the harbor. We don't have time.
That is precisely the negligence that has led you to succumb to Al-Ghul. You reek of it. An invisible soul.
Why is this isn't like all caps?
You cannot see it, but others can. It is making the woman in my company sick. No, you don't. You need to get another drink. Occidental Aplo Group B4 is done begging for help. You gave the world eugenics, electricity. You dominated lesser cultures, like the deformed Hemians and the Inuit. You will be superseded.
Bro, I'm just trying to do my job, please.
Just out of reach. It must be the one that opens the door to the harbor.
Enough with this. Bring your the walls will be lined with bottles of Al-Ghul. Your beloved.
Ask what kind of races there are first. Classification is core to this stuff.
Do you?
There are three categories of race. Tipa, the heroic races. Tibe, the servile races. And the vile CF race, Cauldron of Pederasty. Which one do you need education on? I knew you would go straight.
Yes, it would seem nonsensical.
Those are the Simonese, the Areopagite, and the Occidentals. Excluding them, a receding genetic pool has led the Mount on reprehensible. The Vespertines and Messenians of Vesper and Messina. The ancient Meteorans of Meteo by the Golden Pisantic Sea. The Suren of Sur la Clé, and even the North Königsteiners. All the other large mondial civilization, the Mesk, are too yellow and oleaginous.
Yellow.
As an overproduction of sebum. Sebum is leaking into their brains, making them listen to El Mariachi music and eat toxic minced meat. As proven by the Maun and the Mesk, Occidental type A is in retrograde. The Semenese and the Areopagite. The Areopagites are sleek, long-headed. The Simonese are powerful, mesomorphic. The former is an immutable progenitor, unchanged since the latter is...
Nature was not capable of more.
Type B are the unheroic races, amorphous non-competitors of the great race. The Koikos and the Vacholier. They are mud.
The Koikos of Grah, Yugo, Zhimsk, Chest et al. Are what you would call white officer in a suspect description.
Yes. To an untrained eye, the Koiko appear white and pinkish, like a hand's on witch. But look into their eyes and you will see. They are often in this pinkness is a racial quality that has to be earned through centuries of advanced ballistic warfare and cultural domination. The Koiko, the countless micro-nationalities of Grad, are all inexplicably obsessed with Potat. The Revacholians, halfway between Type A and the racial cauldron, too mixed to know right from wrong. You tried your degenerate.
Is it 82,000 years that we've been recording history? You have very little idea of what is happening, but that seems a little off.
Revolution came to have a shawl from Grad. In Zaraz, written potato card. The Revolution is fatal familial insomnia. A hereditary prion condition passed from the Koi enough of Tibet mediocrity. Tips, the F, are a museum of failed chimeric experiments and tragic maladaptation. It would be cruel to entertain ourselves with their deformity. You understand nothing. To solve the great race enigma, you need to internalize what you have heard here today. Then return to me. This clarity does not come instantly.
Bro. I'm not really sure about this. Go by the absurdity. Okay, let's give it a go, I guess.
I cannot possibly imagine what else we have to discuss, Tibere Vasholia.
He does not so much as glance at the object.
Stop showing me your pathetic cup. I have... The unpromising race pupil return. There is nothing funky about tips. The F are a museum. Lesser, the mosquito is born sterile.
It seems unlikely that two human beings produce genetically sterile offspring.
I got...
Yes, it is cruel to entertain ourselves with... I cannot possibly imagine what else we have to discuss. Don't be vulgar. White or not has got little to do with this. The race enigma runs much deeper than that. Mr. Clare is a man of vision and means. Also, to serve is noble. It takes discipline. Your petulant individualism has only contributed to your race failure. It is, of course, you are, Revachol. Above all, rampant multinational finance still reigning large. Tell me, where have you gotten your love of pathetic communism from? Degenerate youth culture? Rock and roll music?
It's true, I'm a rock and roll star and a rebel.
Stop explaining yourself. No one cares about your beliefs. The conversation has moved on. Of course it does. I am not surprised you enjoy it so much. This has happened to many of the side products of the inevitable cultural victory of the Seminese race. What you need is to come to terms with extinction and never getting into...
I think this racist is better than the last, but the next racist will be...
That will be the...
He will grant us three wishes.
Your pedomorphic friend has quick wits.
The lieutenant...
You should keep him close. The congenital defect. Racists are generally not very good examples of.
Welcome to Revachol. You hear it? He must think redheads are immigrants.
I am not like them. I am craniometric perfection.
perfection.
I've taken the trouble to permanently draw a phrenologic grid on my skull.
The drawings are precise and look true to their pseudo-scientific ambitions. One thing, however, it is not entirely free of throwbacks in the phylogenetic tree. His large jaw, for example, could be a trait indicative of criminalism. Also, his earlobes could be small.
You exhibit forward projection of the jaw, indicative of schizophrenia and sexual inaccountability. From a pure, it is impossible to see any more of your bone strut. This leads me to conclude, you are not a police officer. You are a common. Your racial heritage is uninteresting.
Bro, this is not cool, man. Just let me through, bro. Literally. My brain is almost melted, by the way. I feel like I need to end this episode here as well. And probably gonna stop playing some main Disco Elysium. Because it requires so much attention, like, so much stuff. I have to read everything truro. And I don't wanna miss stuff, so I'm gonna end this episode here. And also stream as well. So yeah.